So, came 6th Hijrah and the Prophet announced that I am going for Umrah. Now we know that he cannot enter Makkah. He has migrated from Makkah to Medina. He is in Medina. For 5 years he never went to Makkah. And the Makkans were all enemies, wouldn't allow him to come. 6th Hijrah came and the Prophet announced, I am going for Umrah. 1500 people at least accompanied him from Medina, telling him, Ya Rasulullah, how can we go to Umrah? They won't allow us enter. The Prophet said, I am not out to fight. I am going for Umrah, for Ziyarat of Kaaba. How can they stop me? So the Prophet advanced. As he advanced and as he reached few miles away from Makkah, the people of Makkah became aware that Muhammad is coming. So they thought that he has come to fight again. We are not out to fight. Why is he coming? So they sent someone. When he came, the Prophet told him that I have not come to fight because there is no fight. I have just made a niyyah and a decision that I am coming for Umrah, for ziyarah of Holy Kaaba. And I don't think why you should stop me. All these people are coming. You can see we have no ammunition. And the camels we have, they are all for Qurbani, because in those days, camels for sacrifice were always marked. So they all bear the marks of sacrifice. You can see them. We are just coming for Qurbani and we are coming for Umrah. So two or three people came and went, giving the message to people of Makkah that Muhammad is not coming to fight. Let him enter. But the people would not. Especially Abu Sufyan said no. So the Prophet sent Uthman. Why he sent Uthman? He sent Uthman ibn Affan because he is from Banu Umayyah. And that the strong stalwarts of opposition in Makkah at that time were from Banu Umayyah, Abu Sufyan included. He sent Uthman and told him, go and tell your people that Muhammad is genuinely concerned about Umrah only. He will stay there for 3 days, do his Umrah and come back. When Uthman reached there and Abu Sufyan welcomed him, he said, Uthman, glad that you have come. What is the position? And he explained. So he said, Uthman, you want to do Umrah? Go and do. But Muhammad can never enter Makkah. So Uthman said, Abu Sufyan, there can be no Umrah by Uthman without the Prophet being together. If you don't allow me, then I go back. He said, you can't go back. You are held hostage. So Uthman was captured and kept as hostage. Here, the Prophet was gradually, he was waiting for it. But when he found that there is no answer, people started talking, Ya Rasulullah, Uthman must have been killed. So the Prophet said, we advance. Came to a place which is known as Dhul Hulaifa. Even today, that place is there. When he came at Dhul Hulaifa, the Prophet said, make a niyyah of ihram. So all of them wore ihram. Once ihram was worn, now there was no doubt that this is Umrah. When the people now coming to see the Prophet, saw the Prophet and the people with ihram. The Prophet said, now look, this is ihram. We have come and in ihram we can't even take any ammunition or any weapons together. It is haram. So you can't. So the Prophet said, right. Rather than advancing straight onto Makkah, we go right. And there was a valley there which is known as Thaniya. And the Prophet diverted towards Makkah, but rightwards. Makkah, 4 miles around Makkah is haram, remember that. 4 miles around Makkah is haram from various places. The Prophet chose the remote right place, which is known as Hudaybiyah. And he came up to Hudaybiyah and stopped there. Now Hudaybiyah is just the boundary. Enter from Hudaybiyah into Makkah, into haram, and from haram to Makkah. The people came there and said, Ya Rasulullah, enter. He said, I must know first, is Uthman killed or not? If he is killed, then I am entering. If he is not killed, then I shall wait till I get the permission. I don't want to fight. And the news came that Uthman is not killed, but Uthman is only captured as a hostage. So the Prophet said, in that case, we will not advance. Tell them still to give us permission to enter Makkah. So they came and they said, Muhammad this time, Let us come to some compromise, a truce, a suluh. The Prophet said, I am all ready for it. What suluh? So some terms. Hey, what terms? So we can say, for example, that there shall be no war between us for 10 years to come. The Prophet said, that is agreed. What other term? He said, another term is that whoever comes from your side on his own volition to Mecca is welcome during those 10 years for Umrah or for trade. And whoever comes from our side to this place, to your place, should be welcome and should have safe custody. The Prophet said, that is very nice. Whoever deserts you, leaves Islam, comes to us in Mecca, must not be captured or recaptured. He must be allowed free. But whoever deserts us and enters Medina, he must be repatriated. The Prophet said, agreed. Agreed. Finally, you shall not enter Mecca this year. You can come next year. The Prophet said, agreed. So they sat down. And Imam Ali was told to write down the terms. And this is what Imam Ali wrote. هذا ما صالح محمد رسول الله. Of course, he first wrote Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and then he wrote هذا ما صالح به محمد بن عبد الله مع سهيل بن فلان. The name of the person who came from there was Suhail. Just as he wrote this, gentleman who came from Mecca said, Muhammad, had I agreed that you are Rasulullah, then there was no question of suluh. Why are you writing Muhammadun Rasulullah? I don't acknowledge you as Rasulullah. That is one thing. Second thing, we don't know what is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So it must begin with Bismikallahumma, the way we say it. The Prophet said, Ya Ali, write Bismikallahumma. He said, you must now change from Muhammadun Rasulullah to Muhammad and your father's name, Muhammad ibn Abdullah. So the Prophet said, Ya Ali, write Muhammad ibn Abdullah and strike off Muhammadun Rasulullah. Majlisi alayhi rahmah says that when the Prophet told Imam Ali, strike off Rasulullah and write Muhammad ibn Abdullah, Imam Ali said, Ya Rasulullah, I cannot go against your wishes. Your order is order. But how can these hands which have written Rasulullah strike off Rasulullah and write Ibn Abdullah? The answer the Prophet gave is the answer for all the Wahhabis of the world today. This is something, when I read history, I would like to see that I read between the lines. And I read the message. The Wahhabis tell us that Muhammad was a man, died dust to dust. Forget it. Those who have been to Mecca, they must have seen now gradually the name of Muhammad coming out from everywhere. It's only Allah, 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 Allah. As if they knew Allah from the day they were born. Who introduced Allah to us? Muhammad. In Adhan, God has kept Muhammadun Rasulullah with his La ilaha illallah. In Namaz, he has kept Ashhadu Anna Muhammadan Abduhu wa Rasuluhu with La ilaha illallah. But we are wiser than God. So when Imam Ali said, Ya Rasulullah, how can I strike off that? The Prophet said, Uktub Muhammad ibn Abdullah. Write Muhammad ibn Abdullah. لأن محمد رسول الله هو محمد ibn Abdullah. Beautiful. He said, Muhammad Rasulullah is Muhammad son of Abdullah. I mean, there is no difference. That means the Prophet wanted to answer the people to come. That whether you say Muhammad ibn Abdullah or Muhammad ibn Rasulullah, it is one and the same. There is no dichotomy between Risala and the personality of the Prophet. Of course, the Prophet took the letter himself and he wrote. And I now ask those who say he did not know how to write. He wrote. And he did not take the page upside down. He took it straight. He could read also. And he himself wrote, Ibn Abdullah. And the suluh was finalized.